I don't know if you remember, if you were here a fortnight ago, I was here, and I preached on my will or God's will. This is the question. And I'm just going to just relate to that first message to bring the second part of my will or God's will, part two. But Jesus went through an extreme anguish in Gethsemane, which literally means the oil press. Gethsemane means oil press, where he was pressed to great stress. He said, "My soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even unto death," because he saw and he told his disciples what he was about to go through. And in his natural realm, in his natural man, it got to such a point where he said to his father in Mark 14, verse 36, "Abba, Father, my Father, Daddy, all things are possible for you. Take this cup away from me. Nevertheless, not what I will, but what you will be done." And of course, he went back to his disciples. He asked them to pray because he was going through so much anguish and they were sleeping. And he said to them, "Your spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." Because they believed in him, but in a natural way. They believed naturally in him. But today I've got good news that we believe because we've been transformed. We have a new spirit, a perfect spirit. And I went to Hebrews 2 weeks ago, Hebrews 4:13, where it's God said, "And there is no creature hidden from his sight, but all things are naked and open to the eyes of him to whom we must give an account." And the word "open" literally means in Greek, trachelezo. Now, trachelezo literally means to bend back a neck of a victim, to expose the gullet for killing. It's pretty expressionable, isn't it? You know, to bend back the neck of a victim, to expose the gullet for killing. So what is open is that God doesn't want to kill us, but he wants to kill what's killing us, our selfish thoughts, our selfish will, and our selfish desires. He wants to kill that so that we can do God's will. Can you say amen to that? To walk in the spirit and not in the flesh. And the good news is today, you have a new created spirit. Your old spirit has been removed and a new spirit has been placed in you to dominate our natural realm. And today, the good news is it's easier to do than ever before because you're born again of his spirit. 2 weeks ago, I closed on the scripture 1 John 5:14. "Since we have this confidence, we can also have great boldness before him. For if we ask anything agreeable to him, his will, he will hear us. And if we know that he hears us in whatever we ask, we also know that we will have obtained the requests we ask for." So what I closed on was that if we continue to put things forward to God, say, "God, this is what I would like to do. This is my will. This is what I would really like to do. But nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done." You know, if we pray in accordance with God's will, we get sometimes, probably a lot of the times because we commit to God, we'll get what we're asking for. And I think that what I need to share with you today to separate our old nature and our old soul realm. Remember, the mind, the will, and the emotions is what we live in this whole world. That's the trickery of the devil because we're in a natural realm. So everything that we see, everything that we feel, everything that we think, you know, is influenced by the things of this world, the natural world. But God in us, the redemptive work that he's doing in us is in accordance with a perfect spirit. He's replaced our old spirit and the nature of that old spirit stained with sin as the soul realm is, and he's placed a brand new spirit that's perfect. So God looks at your spirit and says, "You're perfect." Colossians 2:11, Passion Translation. "Through our union with him, we have experienced circumcision of the heart. All of the guilt and power of sin has been cut away and is now extinct because of what Christ the Anointed One has accomplished for us. So in the Old Testament, the circumcision of the flesh, see, the natural realm in the Old Testament was cut away. But in the New Testament, it's a circumcision of the heart, which is spiritual, you can't see. It's a spiritual text. My body is not new, but it's being renewed, like yours is. What changed was my spirit. Jesus cut away the power my sin nature had over me. How incredible it is to be born again of the Spirit. The results. The mystery of a born again person you cannot see. It's the new spirit working within. People that knew you before can only see that something has changed in you. But one thing I do notice, that there's something different in you. Can't touch it, can't explain it, but there's something different about you. And you know that when you come to Christ and you live in Christ, people see and they notice this, but they just can't reflect it because it's unseen. It is a spiritual thing. And they're not born of the Spirit like you are, but there is a difference in your life. And 2 Corinthians 5:17, he said, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. That's because you have a perfect spirit within you. It's called Christ in you, the hope of glory. The Anointed One and his anointing. James chapter 1 and verse 21 in the Passion again. So this is why we abandon everything morally impure and all forms of wicked conduct. Instead, with a sensitive spirit, we absorb God's word, which has been implanted within our nature. For the word of life has power to continually deliver us. If you don't read the word of God, you'll never grow, you'll never understand. The word of God gets cemented, and the memory of the Holy Spirit brings things to our remember scriptures. Like I shared this morning, all things work together for good. And so that's the mystery, that the word of God transforms us. The word of God comes from that pure spirit. The Bible says to feed the spirit man. And I'm going to use an example right at the end that you'll never forget about feeding the spirit man. Feeding on the word of God, because it has the power to influence our natural soul realm and the things around the world and in it. For the word of life has power to continually deliver us. I just love it. And you know, Nicodemus, you know, a teacher, a ruler of the Jews, you know, Jesus said to him, listen, that which is born of the flesh is as flesh. You are corrupt in your spirit and your soul. And you are, it's impossible to please God. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory. Your spirit's been corrupted. Your soul's been corrupted. Unless one is born, but that which is born of the spirit is spirit. You are born of the spirit. It is spiritual. You have a spiritual life and birth, rebirth. So why do we struggle serving God? He went to great lengths to free us, didn't he? Why do we struggle serving God? The Apostle Paul describes his dilemma. Romans 7:21. Through the Passion, through my experience of this principle, I discover that even when I want to do good, evil is ready to sabotage me. Truly, deep within my true identity, my spirit, I love to do what pleases God, but I discern another power operating in my humanity, waging a war against the moral principles of my conscience and bringing me into captivity as a prisoner to the law of sin, this unwelcome intruder in my humanity. Sin is unwelcome in me because I really desire to please God at all times. Yeah. Verse 24, what an agonizing situation I am in. Who has the power to rescue this miserable man from the unwelcome intruder of sin and death? I give all my thanks to God, for his mighty power has finally provided a way out through our Lord Jesus Christ, the Anointed One. That's the spirit life, the spirit within us. It's much more powerful than our natural flesh, our nature, our spirit, soul, and body that was corrupted and still wants to live a corrupted life. But you're a new creation. The power of God is working in you, and slowly and surely, he said, I'll do a good work in you. How do we now overcome? Verse 23 of chapter 4 in the book of Ephesians. Now it's time to be made new by every revelation that's been given to you, and to be transformed as you embrace the glorious Christ within as your new life and live in union with him. For God has recreated you all over again in his perfect righteousness, and you now belong to him in the realm of true holiness. Romans chapter 12 in the Passion says this, verse 1 and 2. Beloved friends, what should be our proper response to God's marvelous mercies? To surrender yourselves to God, to be his sacred living sacrifices, and live in holiness, experiencing all that delights his heart, for this becomes your genuine expression of worship. Stop imitating the ideals and opinions of the culture around you. In the New King James, it says, don't be conformed to this world. And the concordance says, don't be conformed to this world. This is what it means. All that floating mass of thoughts and opinions that we inhale daily, but be inwardly transformed by the Holy Spirit through a total reformation of how you think. This will empower you to discern God's will as you live a beautiful life, satisfying and perfect in his eyes. I'm going to close with a picture. I'm going to close with a picture of a silkworm. Now, here's the key to the silkworm. Silkworms can only really exist on mulberry leaves. You feed a silkworm mulberry leaves, and this is what you get, a butterfly. How perfect and beautiful is that? So what does the mulberry leaves reflect? If you can only feed on the mulberry leaves, you become like that. If you only feed on the Word of God as a comparison to mulberry leaves, you'll become like that. A new redeemed life in Christ looks like that. A new redeemed life in Christ, God sees that. He doesn't see the worm. He sees that. And he's taking you to that. 1 John 5 from the Passion Translation. I close on this. True love for God means obeying his commands. And his commandments don't weigh us down as heavy burdens. You see, every child of God overcomes the world, for our faith is the victorious power that triumphs over the world. So who are the world conquerors? That's why we're called Victory Church. Defeating its power, those who believe that Jesus is the Son of God.